Warning. What you are about to hear may cure you of your impotence. I'm the Long Wannabe, and welcome to Holding a Grunge. I wanna take a bite on your disco stick. Let's play a love game, play a love game. Do you want love? Are you want fame? Are you in the game? Know the love game. Slaves are working. The blood is on the table. The mouths are choking. I am willing to bet that by judging by that small clip I just showed you, you as the viewer probably thought you were watching Soundgarden. Okay, that makes sense, it's a fair judgment. But what happens to your opinion when I also happen to throw in this little piece of footage? I don't mind stealing bread. Now you're confused. What's going on? Is this Soundgarden? Is this Pearl Jam? Did Eddie Vedder contribute a guest vocal to an early Soundgarden song? Nope. Because back in 1990, there was no band such as Soundgarden or Pearl Jam. Instead, we had what came before those two mammoths of talent. What project did Cornell and Vedder collaborate on? A short-lived band entitled Temple of the Dog. Temple of the Dog was created by Cornell in tribute to his friend Andrew Wood, a fellow grunge rocker who died because of his drug addiction. Wood's bandmates heard about the idea that Cornell was going to create, and they quickly joined in on the dream. Temple consisted of Cornell Matt Cameron, who later became Soundgarden, and Stone Gossard and Matt McCready, the future guitarist of Pearl Jam. Oh, and you can't forget Jeff Ament, PJM's bass player. Eddie came into the group after he had tried out for some other band at the time. He flew into town and Cornell picked him up as the backing vocalist. That explains why Vedder isn't heard that much on the album. A majority of the band's songs were written by Cornell in honor of his late friend. Songs like Reach Down and Say Hello to Heaven are clearly about Andrew Wood. But their most popular song, as well as their first single ever, is the song simply known as Hunger Strike. But it's on the table, the fire's cooking. And the farmer's babies and the slaves are all working. Hunger Strike is a song in which I like to describe as Harmony Heaven. Different from the rest of the other tunes, Hunger Strike consists of a duet between Cornell and Vedder. It's perfect because Cornell's high notes, which are like God, flow wonderfully together with Vedder's beautiful baritone. The song itself is written about a Robin Hood type character, a person who steals food and gives it to those less fortunate. But it's on the table, the fire's cooking. The song is so grand and majestic in its message, it feels more like Robin Hood than the last Hollywood movie. Cornell begins the song with his beautiful voice and he is accompanied by McCready's, or Stone Gossard's, skillful guitar playing. I don't mind stealing bread from the mouths of decadence. Those opening lines alone still make me wish Cornell had his original vocal range. Vedder comes in halfway through the song and makes an impressive impression. How epic does that look? Vedder's presence is so badass. Simple, calm, a beautiful voice filled with passion. It pretty much just says, yeah, I have no idea why the hell I'm singing in this grass. But you know what? I don't care. And look at Cornell shred away on his guitar. Elegance. Pure elegance. Now allow me to point out a few things on the music video. It's really nothing special. Temple of the Dog are doing nothing but playing on the sandy beach. Nothing else. But it technically doesn't have to be about anything else. That's what makes this scenario work. A lot of parody videos mock songs on the beach, but this song and its message outweighs everything else. This video looks like it probably took, 200 bucks to make. The camera people probably just packed up their equipment, drove on down to a beach, and had the band sing a few takes of the song. But Temple of the Dog do nothing but show how important the music is. They don't need any fancy dance steps or overblown special effects to make this song work. The video is simple, the song is sweet, and the talent is pure. It complements itself. And look at that beautiful sunset. It's very suiting for this piece. This video says more about the band's hard work for music rather than the Black Eyed Peas trying to look hip. It's all they try to do. No current band would try to do something this simple anyways. They'd be too scared, it would ruin their image. Yeah. I'm talking to you, Bieber, you six-year-old Usher wannabe. And I just can't believe my first love won't be around, and I'm like, baby, baby. what, 13? You're still a baby yourself! But back to my point. The video is one giant compliment to the song. And what's the best thing about the song itself? The chorus! I'm going hungry. What I meant when I said the song is harmony heaven. The mixed vocals of Cornell and Vedder take me into a whirlpool of magic. It makes me want to go out and feed the hungry myself. No, I don't have any food right here. Eat my shoes. Cows are good for leather in some parts. This is what we make hamburgers out of. Just eat. Eat, my friends. Please, hunger no more, for I shall go hungry. The chorus is beautiful. Vedder makes his talent seem effortless, and listen to Cornell's God note. Oh yeah. He can't really do it anymore, but who can blame him? Since Temple of the Dogs was short-lived, this song wasn't really played much live. But when it was, it sounded better in person than it did on the actual CD. That's when you know a band is truly amazing, when they sound better in the flesh rather than a studio modified CD. Just like twins, so insane. I rest my case. We all know what happened when this band came to an end. Cornell and Cameron went off to create Soundgarden while the remaining members instead made a band called Pearl Jam. It is quite interesting that Cameron is now Pearl Jam's most recent drummer, so in a way, it's like a mini reunion. But recently, Temple of the Dog has had a full reunion. Cornell has made a few appearances on stage with Pearl Jam during their most recent tours, and they do belt out this classic tune. It's funny because everyone calls this a Pearl Jam song which features Cornell, but no. In the minds of us true fans, we know this is a Temple reunion. It's pure magic. Did Temple ever get the recognition they deserved? Not at all. But maybe it's a good thing. Now instead of one talented band, we have two. And it's always fun for us fans to go back and dig up old albums such as this one. So technically I am happy they broke up. But I'm happy in a positive way. I'll take this Harmony Heaven over any emotionless piece of crap any day. Temple of the Dog, thank you. Your musical perfection is God's gift to us. May you ever rest forever in our memories. Well, my viewers, if you excuse me, I'm gonna go out and make another montage. One that makes me look like I actually care about the poor people in the world. Because I do. I really do care about them. Oh, and before I leave, let me just say next week, I'm gonna review You. Not you as the viewers. I'm gonna review the song You. As in, I am talking about you, the people, person. Not the individual. You are an individual. I'm calling you You. So I'm reviewing Y-O-U, not you as in U-turn. The song, yeah, I'm gonna review Candlebox. Bye! Yeah, I'm talking to you, Bieber. That joke is axed.